गुड इवनिंग ऑल। दिव्या मैम सर, वी स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग सर, यू कैन।
गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। वी वेलकम यू टू द वर्चुअल वर्कशॉप ऑन साइंटिफिक राइटिंग फॉर हाई इंपैक्ट जर्नल्स होस्टेड बाय कोंगो बिजनेस स्कूल, अ यूनिट ऑफ कोंगो इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज। Dissemination by way of high quality publications is the most crucial part of any research activity. A proper insight into the aspects of publication would serve as a guide to every researcher for providing quality publications, and this workshop is designed in such a way that it addresses various things like writing and designing manuscripts, identifying and choosing right journals, and most importantly of understanding the different terminologies of impact factor like H-index, I-index, and the citation matrix, and also it concentrates on the plagiarism. With this note, I would like to introduce our resource person, Dr. P. Karthikeyan, Associate Professor, Kongo Business School, who has an immense expertise in writing for high-impact journals. He has also published various manuscripts in peer-reviewed national and international journals, and also has served as reviewer in set of journals. He is an active researcher who is aiming at publications in Scopus and Web of Science journals. And I think his insights into manuscripts preparation and knowledge about the different shades of publication process would add value to our workshop. And before we go further, I request everyone to mute yourselves, and your active participation is important throughout the session. There will be a discussion at the end of the session, so you can ask your questions at the end of the session. And if you have anything important, you can also raise your hand during the session. And I would like to pass on the session to Dr. Karthikeyan. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, organizers. I take this opportunity, along with the organizing committee of Kongo Business School, a unit of Kongo Engineering College, I cordially welcome all the participants who have registered for this particular workshop. Maybe we have part of this particular workshop on three different days. So today we are going to see about how to write research paper, and tomorrow we are going to see how to identify the high impact journals, particularly Scopus journal or Web of Science journals. Then we also slightly move to UGC CAT journals also, though most of the arts and science and state universities are mainly focused on UGC CAT journal. That we are going to discuss on tomorrow. And day after tomorrow, third day, end of the day, where we are going to discuss much on the research concepts, like what do you mean by citations, what do you mean by H-index, what do you mean by impact factor, how to calculate the Scopus index score, or how to identify the different top rating journals. So in this aspect, we are going to discuss, along with the plagiarism, how to reduce the plagiarism. So these contents we are going to discuss in the third day. In between my presentation, if you have any questions, you can always welcome, no problem. The remaining questions you can reserve yourself, so that you can ask at later point of time. In between, if you have any important question, you can ask. Otherwise, you can ask maybe last 15-20 minutes, you can ask any doubt, a number of questions, so that the any other participants are also benefited, right? So with this brief note, today I'm going to straight away I'm going to handle the session on art of writing research paper. I know that there are so many fields in the research. Maybe most of them are from social science, I hope, and we also have some engineering faculty, we also have science faculty. So in this, keeping this mind, I'm going to cover how to write the research paper in high impact factor journals in all the disciplines. Are you able to see the screen, dear participants? Can you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We are able.
Right.
Yes, sir.
So maybe I will share the PPT to you, don't worry about at later point of time. So if you have any important points, you can note out, otherwise I will share my presentation. Right. So dear professors and dear earned the research learners, so I request you all, please mute yourself once again. Thank you. And this scientific writing for high impact factor journals, today it is a need. Every research organization, particularly colleges and universities, they are asking from us, don't publish your research paper in medium quality journals or ISSN journals. We required Scopus journals, we required Web of Science journals. So this is the word where everybody is getting from your boss, you are receiving from your college management. But it is not an easy task. I am telling to you, my dear friends, don't lose your money for publishing your paper in the
Karthik sir, sorry for the interruption. If you can you wear headphone, it's the voice will more clear.
Once
sir
again, come again.
Yes sir.
Can you able to hear now? Is it okay?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Yes sir, it's clear.
Okay, thank you. So what are all the aspects of writing a research paper? So before that I have discussed about why the colleges are asking about the good quality research paper from the researcher as well as the faculty colleagues, because today NIRF ranking, NAAC committee visit or any other ranking purpose, the colleges and universities are asking from us only good quality research papers. Okay, they will count only the Scopus journal, they will count only UGC CAR, at least UGC CAR or a Web of Science journal. Okay. And I can say that if you publish one research paper on a good quality journal, high impact journals like Scopus and Web of Science, it is equivalent to 5 research paper where you are published in the other ISSN journals. And I also advise you to my dear friends, don't lose your money unnecessary for publishing your research paper in predatory journals or cloned journals. Last few years, 5 to 6 years, there is a heavy hidden market in India. They are marketing anything, like they are selling the papers, they are selling the patent. You need not do anything. You simply go and register your PhD. Even PhD is also selling. I'm sorry to say that in this forum, but the thing is that, and what is the purpose we are all doing research, I don't know. But we are having sufficient knowledge, sufficient information with us compared to all other countries. Okay? But we are unable to write or improve our writing skills. So, right, we are going to discuss in this aspect today. For writing a research paper, we need a content, we need a good language, figures and tables. We should also include the literature review part, the introduction, discussion should be effectively presented in the research paper. And very, very important, we should choose the correct journal. We should choose the correct journal. If you take a Scopus, more than 45,000 journals are available. If you take Web of Science, particularly coming from Social Science Citation Index, there were around 10,000 research journals are available. But what we are all doing, we are not waste our time. Unnecessary, we are sending the research paper to some, without the knowledge of the research supervisor or without the knowledge of the co-author, we simply lose our money to publish our research paper in the middle level quality journals or low level quality journals. Dear faculty colleagues, I may say to you, publishing a research paper in high index journal, it will take 1 year or 2 year. 1 year or 2 year. If you want, I will show you the different platform at later point of time. And the research paper also preparation skill, first draft, that is rough draft is very important. And you want to prepare your rough draft and you can submit to the supervisor, co-author, as well as very important, the nativity speaker, the language proof. The language proof is much important. Before sending the research paper, my dear friend, sit with your language teacher or proof reader who can able to solve the grammatical mistake or any other spelling mistakes. After that, you can send it to the or upload into the good quality journal. So this is one important thing. And what is the purpose for writing a research paper? Please to remember yourself and to understand yourself to gain perspective. So dear faculty colleagues and research scholars, so if you forget something, definitely it will not come back. So for that purpose only the research will start to remember. To understand, if you publish your research paper, the others, the readers, who are all readers? The readers may be the future researchers. So they can easily understand and they can also introduce a new concept based on your existing research and also to gain perspective. So if you publish a research paper, you will get a reputation. Your institution will get a reputation. Your co-authors will get a reputation. And not only that, you will get more citation for your research paper. So if you have more citation, more research paper on this particular domain or particular area, you are also get more fund. There is an opportunity to get to attract more fund from the funding agencies. So these are all the reasons behind why we are writing a research paper. And in continuing with our the purpose, the essential for science is to progress, ideal and legal protection of intellectual property. We know that copyright and all important here. To gaining a reputation for many academic institutions, now it is a mandatory, maybe it is an implicit or explicit requirement to publish a research paper. That's what I told you already. If you go for NIRF ranking or NAC accreditation process or any ranking purpose, today the colleges or universities are asked from the research scholars and faculty colleagues to publish a research paper in high impact factor journal. So maybe it is explicit and implicit factors. Dear friends, there are six qualities. According to me, I can say the writing, great scientific writing is start from six important qualities. First one is foci. Foci, I can say it is a foci. First one is a fluid. Your research content, your paper content should be in fluid in nature. Organized manner, okay, should be organized. So dear friends, there should be some sequence. So there should be some sequence. Maybe first chapter is an introduction. And the second chapter is a review of literature. Third chapter is methodology. Under methodology, you may provide 3.1, 3.2, 3.3 like that. 3.1 may be a statement of the problem. 3.2 may be objectives. 3.3 may be research methodology, sampling, conceptual framework, etc., etc. And the fourth chapter is results and discussion. And the fifth one is a conclusion. And the sixth chapter is a policy implications, limitations, and future research. I will press the F5, don't worry. I just maintaining that typing the matter. Okay. Okay. So the five chapters are important here. First one is a fluid. I mean the foci we discussed, fluid, organized, and we have six chapters. I have told you six chapters, organized content. Okay, first article, when we start writing on article, so first chapter is introduction. Here we want to provide more citations on your research work. Then come to review of literature, where you want to provide more existing review, where it is started, the problem, where it is exist, and you want to identify the research gap, everything, and how your research is different from the previous research. So everything you want to give the answer in the review of literature. Today, for writing a review of literature is need more time. So previously, every researcher written the review of literature only for namesake purpose, but now review of literature has getting more important, even for publishing a research paper in impact factor journals. There are so many researchers are doing meta-analysis, META, meta-analysis, for exclusively for review of literature purpose. And your research article should be in clear, concise in nature, convincing to the readers. I may say that readers means whoever is reading your research paper, maybe a reviewer, editor, are the researchers. They are all readers, and it should be very interesting topic. I may quote on good examples. 2019 December, the COVID-19 was started, and first the COVID patient was identified at China. Dear faculty colleagues, I may say to you, there were around 45,000 research papers was published by a Chinese research scholars between the period February 2020 to April 2020. Within a period of 3 months, 40,000 research articles related to COVID-19 was published by the Chinese researcher, and everything it is listed in the Scopus and Web of Science journals. So you want to identify the hot topic, dear faculty colleagues, you want to identify the hot topic and interesting topic. And so many researchers, if you take a management and commerce and social science researcher, they go for ratio analysis, working capital performance, customer satisfaction, employee satisfaction. So these are all outdated topic. The research need the passion and interest among yourself. There are so many research topics are amongst us, but there are lot of problems related to society, related to communities, related to economy, but we are all go with only the existing problem. Nobody is interested to get a new problem. Okay, that is very, very important. So six call mark on great scientific writing. And why to write research paper? Maybe I told you already implicit and explicit reasons. And apart from that, research findings and discoveries with the hope of improving knowledge. If you are publishing your research paper, that research paper will give more idea, more information for the future researcher. Practically, I am speaking to you to get more funding. Yes, I already told you. So if you are publishing the good quality research paper and in the Scopus indexed journals or Web of Science journals, there is a high possibility to receive a funding from the different funding agencies. If you take the funding agencies like CERB, that is coming under DST, and more CSIR, and different funding agencies are providing funding only for the good publications. To get promoted, to get a job, and to keep your job. These are all other implicit reasons behind that why we are writing a research paper. And what is empirical article? What is empirical articles? Empirical articles will include charts, graphs, and statistical analysis. So whatever the articles we are writing will include the charts, graphs, or figures, and also speaks about different statistical analysis using the hypothesis, Can you able to hear?
Sir, we are
hearing. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. He is still not in the presentation mode.
Dear faculty colleagues, there is some problem in the presentation mode. Anyway, I will try. If not, slide is not changed, please let me know. Okay? Can you able to be visible now?
Yes, sir. We could able to
yes,
see.
Sir.
Okay. If slide is not changed, please let me know. Okay. The empirical article, the empirical research article include charts, graphs, and statistical analysis.
Excuse
Maybe
me,
it
sir.
Is between, yeah?
आप ये स्लाइड्स हमें बाद में मेल पे दे दीजिएगा अभी अगर टेक्निकल इश्यू आ रहे हैं
मैम आई कांट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट यू आर सेइंग प्लीज कम्युनिकेट
आई एम सेइंग यू आर गिविंग इन ईमेल बाय ईमेल
या वी विल सेंड टू यू डोंट वरी
इट इज गिविंग सेंड अस ओके थैंक यू सर
ओके एंड द बिब्लियोग्राफी और रेफरेंसेस कैन बी एट एंड ऑफ द योर आर्टिकल दिस इज नॉर्मली कॉल्ड एज एन एम्पिरिकल रिसर्च आर्टिकल And these are all the some qualities of the good paper. Can you able to see screen now?
Yes, sir.
Essential qualities of good paper.
No,
Excuse
sir.
Excuse me.
No, sir.
Yes, sir. Please try with once again. Go to the slide show and try with from presentation from the current slide.
How?
Essential qualities, sir.
Yeah. Can you able to see now?
Yes,
Essential
sir.
Quality.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. So the essential qualities of good paper should be a good content, clarity, and a concept, addressing the business problem. Languages should be effectively written, presentation style, and use of data in the paper. Dear faculty colleagues, most of the papers are rejected because we are using very old data. In the case of secondary data for economics and finance area. So now we are in 2021. But when you look into the different papers and Indian authors they have published, they might quietly they have used the data up to 2017 and 18. It is all updated. So while you are using the secondary data, it is very important, and also primary data. When you are mentioning in the research design or research side, okay. When you are using research side at the time of written and research methodology part, suppose in case you are telling about the primary data collection was collected from the respondent between the date, if you are mentioned the date, that also you must very carefully you want to write. And it is not, I can say that it is not necessary. Okay, writing the collection of the data and the data period is not necessary to mention in the methodology part in case of primary data. Size of the report, maybe 10-15 pages is more than enough. So dear researcher, most of the people, what they are doing, they simply convert the research research project, maybe their students research project, or they also convert the research thesis, MPhil research thesis or PhD research thesis. I am also part of the review team on very good quality journals as well as some Indian journals. When I looking onto the Indian journals, I am a part of the editorial board as well as reviewer, I may find out the authors will send the research paper without made any alterations and corrections. If you take example, the table number 1, and after the table number we have table number 7, they simply send table number 1 and table number 7 without make any alterations, and without make any alteration even in the page number, without make any alteration even in the introduction part, review part, abstract part, everything. They simply cut some portion and they will add, they will not add, they will simply cut and remove something and they will send it as a research article. It is not a good practice. So it is an easy method. If you are having a research scholar, if you are having a PG student, there is a lot of chances are available. You can convert your research project into paper, but we need more precise and concise while you are converting the research project into paper. We want to work at least 5 to 10 days. We want to work out. Still, you want to collect the data. If it at all required, you can go and study the review of literature. You collect the review of literature from good quality journals. Don't collect the review of literature from not in the proper journals. So you may write like Emerald Journal, Sage, elsewhere. So many journals are available. Then size of the report, good writing skills, footnotes and citations. So citation is very, very important. Citation is very important, and publication in good journals. Publications in good journals. So dear faculty colleagues, just a second. I am sharing one research paper to you all. I am sharing one research paper to you. Just a second. Can you able to see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. So this is a research paper published by one of my Indonesian friend in the area of subjective norms and academic dishonesty, a decision tree algorithm analysis. So you may see here more number of citations are given. Okay, see here citation. If at all not possible to provide the names here, you may also use this number format, the number format. So mostly in the science and engineering background, IEEE paper and all, they will use this type of style. Okay, this type of style. So where you may find this paper as recently published in one of the Scopus journal in March 2021 issue, and where you may get the recent data, you can check it. The first chapter is introduction. Second chapter is,
sir.
Yeah. Excuse me.
Paper is not visible, sir.
I'm sorry.
Sir, only PPT is visible, sir.
Just a minute, ma'am. Now, can you able to see?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay, we can see.
Yeah. So this paper is published by the co-authors from Indonesia, subjective norms and academic dishonesty as a decision tree. Hello? Kindly mute yourself. Somebody is making noise. Kindly mute yourself. I hope Hema Patel, please. Sorry. Okay. So this paper is written by one of my friend who is in Indonesia, Patrioni and Sukirno. They have published a research paper, Subjective Norms and Academic Dishonesty. This is a one method where they are adopting the citations. Instead of saying that the author's name in the bracket, they are simply saying that the reference number, and end of the paper they have given the references. They have given the references in the order wise. So journal wise it may be different. Journal wise it may be different. And I may also go with another journals. This is also a paper published in InterScience journal, International Journal of. Can you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, International Journal of Business Innovation and Research. It is also published in this month, November. April month 2021. This is a Scopus journal, empirical study on buying behavior of selected durable goods with reference to the female consumer. And this paper has written by me as well as one of my friend who is in Singapore. Okay. And this paper is published in InterScience journals, where I have used the citations here. See here, I have used the names and the year. So this paper was uploaded in 2018. Dear faculty colleagues, I have uploaded this paper in the year 2018 and 19, but paper was published only in this month, after 2 years. So during the time of upload, I have updated the review. See, the recent review I have updated here. Look into that. Along with the old review, I have also included some of the recent reviews. See, here, this is one recent review, this is one recent review, this is another one recent review. I will give the examples. Just a second. Can you able to see screen now?
Yes, we can see the screen. Yes, sir.
InterScience submission. Okay. I hope you understand. Can you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this paper was uploaded, empirical study on buying behavior of selected durable goods with reference to the female consumers. This paper was uploaded 30th March 2019. And after 2 years, this paper was published this month. Why I am talking here? At the time of writing a research paper, at the time of upload the research paper, you should give the recent reviews. Recent reviews. Along with the old review, you also want to provide the recent reviews related to your research. And based on the research, see, this is my format. First one is I have used introduction. Then I have written review of literature. Third, I went to research methodology. 3.1 is a research gap. 3.2 objectives. 3.3 research design. 4 methodology. And 3.5, I have used conceptual framework and the model. And fourth chapter, the data analysis and discussion part, where one by one, first one demographical and factor analysis, I have given the results. Then reliability analysis, measurement model, structural equation modeling. Everything it is including with subheading. This is a structural equation modeling. And path analysis, 4.8 is Putnam's for chi-square test. I have used here Putnam's of fit for structure model. And finally, that results and discussion is a fifth chapter, and last chapter is suggestion and recommendation. In the suggestion and recommendation, along with suggestion and recommendations, I also add the policy implications, scope for further research, and limitations of the study. If you are providing the suggestion and recommendation along with the results part, then directly you can write in the sixth chapter policy implications, scope for future research, and limitations of the study. This is the general structure of any research paper, particularly in the social science discipline. So you can write here the references. The references are followed APA style, American Psychological Association style. Alphabetically, I have arranged here, right? This is the way where you want to write the research paper. So dear faculty colleagues and the research scholars, so writing a research paper is easy, but publishing in good quality research journals is very difficult. Required at least 2 years period, required at least 2 years period. For publishing this research paper, I have not paid a single paisa from my pocket. See here, so many paper I have uploaded in IndraScience alone. Check it here, that this paper was published in 2020 December, another paper. Now it is available in the online. This paper is available on the line, online now. So within this paper was uploaded 2018 and published 2020, uploaded in 2019, published in 2021. Look into that. After one revision, okay, after one revision, these are all the different matters here. And see, one more paper is also accepted. This, see, look at that. This paper I have uploaded in 19 September 20, and finally this paper was accepted. Okay, this paper was accepted in 14th February 2021. Within 6 months or maybe 5 months, this paper was accepted. It is also Scopus indexed journal, again from IndraScience platform. Within five months the paper was accepted, but I don't know when it is going to publish. So this is the final version of the paper I have uploaded. See, look into that, the final version of the paper. Can you able to see the screen now? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yes, this is a paper, recent paper, where this paper was accepted. Development of scorecard to measure the satisfaction and happiness in higher education. So this paper was written by the different joint authors from Manipal Institute of Technology and from the Christ University, Bangalore, and along with me. So this is the final paper. So look into that, the first abstract followed by abstract keywords and introduction. We have given more citations here, more citation, the recent citations also added. So 2017, 2018, see, look into the 2020 citations. We have given 2020 citations, okay? Then followed by introduction, theoretical foundation. Definitely it is required for this paper. That's what we have given along with some hypothesis. Then I have added the different hypothesis, the linkages on research based on my review of literature and research gap I have given here separately. Then third chapter, see, look into the different style I have written in the review of literature. In the theoretical framework model, we have given the different dimension. These are all the others they have studied in this dimension, these factors and the description. So this is a PERMA model dimension. We used PERMA model is a positive emotion, engagement, relationship, meaning in life, accomplishment. So here, based on that, we have framed one research model. See, look into that research, our research model. Then come to third chapter is a research methodology. Third chapter is a research methodology, and framed by, then fourth chapter is results and discussion. We used the same model for framing the result. then re-specifies him and everything we have discussed here. And finally, fifth chapter is conclusion and future work. I have included only 5 chapters here. Then references. References. See, we have provided more than 50-60 references for this paper. Okay, this is also again, this is accepted paper in the Scopus journals. So for that journal also, I have not paid any single paisa. So that's what I am, and again I am telling to you, my dear friends. So publishing research paper is very, very difficult. So, but simply what we are all doing, we are all paying money and we are all losing our money because this paper was not indexed at all. Okay. Yes.
Sir, how can publish paper without money or without any?
Yeah, ma'am. I will come to this question later, but for your benefit, I am telling to you, don't worry.
Okay,
for
sir,
your information, the Scopus and Web of Science paper, you need not pay any paisa.
Yes, sir.
Mostly, if your paper in subscription-based paper, then you need not pay a single paisa. If your paper want to publish in the open access, then you want to pay a money. But if you are going to publish your paper in the subscription base, then you need not pay a paisa. Okay?
Okay.
Mostly all Scopus, 90% of the Scopus paper and Web of Science papers are all not charging a money from the authors. Just a second. Is my screen is visible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay.
I hope this slide we have discussed. This thing, can you able to see them now? Things to consider before writing slide. Things to consider before writing. Can you able to see?
No, sir.
Sir.
Quality is appearing, sir.
Oh, sorry. Okay, fine. Are you able to see now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes.
Things to consider before writing for others. Time to write the paper. Tables, figures, read references, please, important. Choose journals, tentative title and summary, and choose co-authors. These are all things to consider before writing. So first of all, we require only tentative title, not exactly the title. Only tentative title is more than sufficient for starting your research work. These are all the questions to be answered before you write. Think about why you want to publish your research work. There are many reasons, not for implicit or only on explicit reasons. Or is it any new or interesting thing you are going to publish? Is it a current hot topic? That's what I told you, Chinese. More than 40,000 research papers was published by Chinese only within 3 months. The hot topic. Still, there is a huge demand in the COVID. So you can choose a COVID-related topic. There is a high chance to publish or accept your research paper. And you provide solution to some difficult problem, yes. Are you ready to publish at this point? If you say yes to all the questions, whatever I have raised, then you can start your preparation for writing your manuscript. And dear faculty colleagues, and my dear friends, there are 3 different types of papers or manuscripts are available. One is full articles or original articles or research articles. Full articles are empirical research articles or original articles or research articles. Second one is letters and rapid communications.
Normally, in the second type of research papers or a short communication, the editor will ask from the experts or the authors to submit the research paper. Normally, editor will request the authors, if you are a good author or if you are well versed or expert in the particular field, and editor will ask from you to submit the research paper for this particular issue, maybe short note or short communication. This is the second part. Third part is a review of literature based article, review papers. So you need not take it as a research or writing as a research paper. First thing, you can also publish your research paper based on review of literature, only from existing research, based on the earlier research, what the others are did, and how you are going to use, how you are going to identify the research gap. So only review or conceptual related paper. This is a third type of paper. Here in the research review related or conceptual related paper, it is not required questionnaire instrument, it is not required any secondary data tools or primary data tools such as chi-square, ANOVA or SIM model or anything. Simply, you are studying the papers from the different journals and make it, compile it, write it, and use some methodology. Now I told you meta-analysis or software they are using. There are so many research papers are now publishing using only review of literature. They are not using any tools and techniques for analyzing. And select the best journal for submission. Please look at your references. Okay, suppose at the time of writing a research paper, are you also seeing your research paper, your reference research paper, in the reference sections where it is published, you can look into that. Then you can concentrate to submit your research paper on same research journal. Then there is a high possibility to accept, and review recent publications in each candidate on that particular journal. And ask yourself whether this journal is a peer reviewed, whether this journal's, who is their target audience, who is reading your research paper, what is the average time to print, and what is the journal impact factor. So average time to print means, how we can calculate average time to print. Suppose today you are sending, your paper will be sent for revision after 1 month. The revision will take place 3 months. After revision, the first correction will reach to you, and you have allotted 1 month deadline for submitting the first correction. After that, if it is necessary, the editor will send to again revision, a reviewer, otherwise the paper will accept. So maybe within eight months, your paper will be accept. But we may not give the guarantee after next month the paper will be published. There are so many papers in the list, okay, in the articles in press list. So definitely after acceptance, maybe it will take 1 year or sometime 2 year, the paper will be take to publish. So this is called as an average time to publish. And the journal's impact factor, you also want to look into what is the journal impact factor. So the detailed discussion on the journal's impact factor, where we are going to discuss on the third day of our workshop. And what makes good manuscript? It contains clear, useful, existing scientific knowledge, message, logical manner. Please, material, research material, methods should be transmitted, and the message should be clearly informed to you. And please, very important, don't use palabala or kalagala languages. Word is very important. Research paper should be 5,000 to 7,000 words, maximum 5,000 to 7,000 words. So if n words are enough, no need to go for n plus 1, like nothing but it is clear from the above table shows that these type of words are not required. It is not a thesis work. We are writing a article. So journal space is precious, and don't lose your space. So because some of the journals, they are charging the money from the others if you are exceed the page limit. Okay. And very, very important, dear faculty colleagues, if you want, you can take a snapshot also. Structure of your research paper. Title is a face of your research paper. Other names, abstract, introduction, problem, results, discussion, conclusion, acknowledgement, appendices, references. And the title is a face of your paper, face of your paper, other names and affiliations, followed by abstract. Dear faculty colleagues, abstract is a heart of your paper. Introduction is a hand of your paper. And the conclusion is smile of your paper. Conclusion is a smile of your paper. So title, that is a first impression, is the best impression. First impression is the best impression, the face, right? Then other names, abstract, your heart. Introduction, your hand. And finally, your results. After results discussion, you are providing the information in the conclusion part. That information should be a smiled one. That is smile of a paper. Right? This is a two different models, hourglass model and king model. Hourglass model is introduction, body, discussion, and king model is a title followed by title, abstract, introduction, body of the content, discussion, references. Normally, most of the researcher, they are following king model for writing any research article. And please take a snapshot of this also. So first, dear faculty colleagues, very, very important this slide. If you are thorough with the particular slide, if you are thorough with this particular slide, your entire review process is over. Entire review process is over. Please take a snapshot. First one, define the problem. After define the problem, you are going to make an analysis on review of literature. Okay, review of literature. And simultaneously for writing a review of literature, we need some research gap we are going to identify. Methodology also we are going to identify. Then after methodology, we are going to write the results and discussion part. Then conclusion, and finally it comes on introduction. Finally it comes on introduction. Just a second. Dear faculty colleagues, see here, look into the diagram here. First, we are define the research problem. Then after research problem, we go with the literature review, then formulate the model. Then we finalize the tables and figures. We simultaneously, we write review of literature, write methodology, write results, discussion, tables, figures, everything we are written. Finally, we go with the conclusion part. Conclusion. After conclusion, we want to start introduction. What we will do all normally, we will start with the introduction first, but it is wrong. For writing a research paper, we want to go with the backwards. That's what I told you. Title should be tentatively in nature. When you start the research work, title should be on tentative. No need of fixation of the title. title at first itself. Title should be changed at later point of time. After writing introduction, we want to start right on abstract. Then finish your research paper. Okay. Look into that. This is the format. Once again. Yeah. Write backwards. Write backwards. What is write backwards? Sorry. Yeah. I am coming. I'm very sorry. Yeah. Can you able to see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
So first we want to finish the figures, then start with the methods, results and discussion, then conclusion, introduction, abstract, finally title. And dear faculty colleagues, each section has a definite purpose. Each section has a definite purpose. So let's start with the tentative title. Don't write introduction first. First to complete the methodology part, figures, tables, then review of literature part, conclusion, then finally introduction, and later on abstract. But normally the conferences and all, the organizer will ask from us, please submit the abstract first. But when we want to write abstract, the abstract should be right when you have completed the paper. If you are completed the paper only, the others can be eligible to write the abstract. But normally we will not do. What we will do, simply copy from two lines from some other paper and another two lines from some other paper, and we will submit as an abstract. But it is a wrong. Right. So this is the method used for engineering and science, IMRAD method. Introduction, method, results and discussion. Before that, title, authors, abstract and keyword. It is a common one for any type field they will use. IMRAD, generally they use only four chapters in the engineering and mostly in science backgrounds. But this is a full science, mathematics and science, pure science background faculty members, they use title, abstract, keywords, introduction, preliminaries, definition and notations. They can use in the preliminaries. They can also go with the new theorem from the existing research, definition, example, theorem and proof, go with the conclusion and references part. Yes. Now I am one by one. We will discuss what is title, how we can develop a title and all. So remember, reader's attention is important for writing a title. And please, the reviewers will check whether the title is specific or not. Title should be very specific. It should be relevant with the manuscript. And editors will first look into the title. And based on the title, they will decide whether this article is matched with the need or scope of this journal or not. Okay. Avoid technical jargon and abbreviations in the title. Very, very important. Don't use abbreviations in the title. Don't use technical jargon in the title. And I told you already, the title, it gives the first impression. It is a face of your research paper. Okay. And title should be unique and memorable. Don't copy it on earlier researchers. It should be unique one. It should be memorable one. and the keywords must be given in the as per the title. Okay, and title should not be too long, very very important, 4 lines, 5 lines and all. 2 lines is more than sufficient, and title is not a replacement for the abstract, and usually not a sentence, very important. Don't replicate from the abstract, don't as like a sentence. And very very important, my dear friends, we mainly use the word called a and or the. I can say that these words should be avoid at the time of writing a title. Okay, there are more catchy words are there. Don't go with an, a, the. These type of words can be avoid. It is not like a sentence. Title is not a sentence. If you are looking the paper articles from any good journals or engineering field or engineering journals or science journals, you should not find the word with, I mean, title start with the a or an or the. But the social science researchers are normally using these words, but it should be avoid. And phrases to avoid: investigation, study, novel, facial, studies on. These words are also to be avoid in the title. Okay, a study on, maybe avoid. Yeah, investigation on, please avoid. There are so many catchy words are available. Please choose these type of words. Don't choose these type of words when you are writing a research paper. I just make it as a one change in the research title. Can you able to see the screen example?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, thank you. This is the original title, and I have revised into the different title. Look into that. First title, it is maybe like a 3-4 lines, and I have just converted into 3 lines. Original title is effects of routing flexibility, sequencing flexibility, and scheduling decision rules on the performance of FMS simulation modeling and analysis. And one of the author has requested to me, please change the title into memorable manner. Then I just make it as memorable manner, as like effects of flexibility and scheduling decisions on the performance of an FMS, semicolon, simulation modeling and analysis. That's all. It is more popularity, and even this paper was also accepted. It is not my paper, it is one of my friend paper, and it has receiving more citation, because when the editor has looked into that paper, the first they can see about the title. Even before sending to the reviewer, the title can be looked into the by editor, and based on the title they first look into abstract, then keyword, then only he can look into the main body of the research paper. Well, next one, abstract. Dear faculty colleagues and my dear research friends, please write the abstract after conclusion of your research paper, or after conclude of your research paper. Don't write your abstract at first itself. We are all making a mistake. Please, please avoid. Abstract should be right after finishing of our research paper. This is a critical part. That's what I told you, it is a heart of the research paper. Okay, the main objective. Please state only main objective. State some important results. You can use the words we studied. If you are co-author, we studied, we introduced, we emphasized. Okay, in this paper, these type of words are important while you are writing abstract. And keywords, avoid acronyms, write and rewrite until flawless will come. Dear faculty colleagues and my dear research friends, research scholars, the abstract should be 200 to 300 words, maximum 300 words. Some research journals, they are requested to submit the abstract within 100 words. So accordingly, you want to prepare the abstract. And abstract should stand alone. Avoid using jargon. My dear friends, this is The abstract is the advertisement for your journal, or sorry, for your article. If they read, then definitely the readers will get some attention. Based on the reading interest of the abstract only, they can decide whether they will go for full paper or not. Avoid using jargon. You must be accurate and specific. Use the words which reflect to precise meaning. Follow word limitation. That's what I told you, 100 to 300 words. And in the abstract, please specify problem, method use, major findings and conclusion. Citation is not acceptable in the abstract. Okay, no need to cite. Okay, no need to give any references or citations on your previous research where you have referred. It is not required in the abstract. It is required only in the introduction part. And this is a separate structured format where we can follow for submission of the research paper in Emerald journals. So normally in the Emerald journals, they requested us to submit the abstract in the following format, like purpose, design, methodology, then followed by purpose and design, research limitations should be specified, implications, originality, keywords, and paper type. Paper type may be research article, or review-based article, or conceptual paper that you want to specify. This is only the abstract format which is applicable for submission in Emerald journals. We have 3,000 to 5,000 Emerald journals are available in all the fields, mostly in social science, science and humanities field. So many journals are available in Emerald. Again, it is also part of the Web of Science and Scopus indexed journal. Mostly 99% of the Emerald journals are all part of the Scopus and Web of Science journals. And followed by abstract, we discussed on title, then abstract, then we want to move to keywords. Keywords are your labels of your manuscript. It is a critical to correct indexing and searching. So others, other readers can see first keywords, then only they can go for search on the internet and browsing for further reading. Don't use too broad or too narrow words. And unless otherwise it is a familiar by all, the abbreviation should be avoided. If it is a firmly acceptable abbreviations, okay. Yes, like a DNA, FDA, FIA, it's mostly the researcher are known. But if the abbreviations are not known by all the researcher and reviewers, but don't use abbreviations. Okay, check the guide for others. Number, label, definitions, maybe 6 to 7 guide keywords is more than sufficient. Don't write 10 or 11 keywords. Next, followed by keywords, introduction. In introduction chapter, you want to build a theory, state why study is important. And meantime, I can also say that you want to point only why the study is important. Don't use the word, nobody in the world have used this research, I am your first researcher or conducting this study. These type of words should be avoided in your research paper. So many people are making a mistake in the research gap, what the people will do. So this is the first time in the world I am doing a research. So, but maybe this topic is a consumer behavior. So many have did. But again, what they have told, this is the first attempt where we are made to find out the suitable result on consumer behavior. I don't know. Consumer behavior is a topic from 1970s. So provide brief theoretical background, provide citation if required. That's what I told you. Very, very important. 1 or 2 or maximum 4 or 5 citations are required for introduction part. And also the very latest citation if possible. And the introduction should be convinced readers. Describe the problem, should be provide more consistent related to the nature of the journals. And please introduce some main scientific publications in the introduction part. original and important works can be cited in the introduction area. And these are all the some drawbacks. Too wordy. Don't use the word jargons, novel, first time, first ever. I told you maybe two slides back. So don't use the word called paradigm changing, springly. More words than necessary. Never use more words. Okay, that's what I told you. If it n words is okay, then stick on with only n words. Don't go for n plus one words or n plus two words. Okay. And so then followed by methodology, only detail. Okay, detailed prescription, detailed sections is required. Methodology parts, supplementary materials if required, then you can provide in the appendices. Otherwise, no issue. You need not submit. If it is available in some of the journals, you can provide the appendices or supplementary material. Data collection is a questionnaire. Instrument are not at all required. You need not submit as a appendix section. If unless otherwise the journal is asking, you need not submit the questionnaire or appendices or supplementary material. This is a result. Normally this section is related to engineering background, how the results are drawing. Okay, then discussion part. This is the selling on your research area, selling on your research topic. Data. So many manuscripts are rejected because the discussion part is weak and reiterate the results. What they will do? Simply copy and re-alter the results. So it is not acceptable. Compare the published results. What we will do? Say when we start our research, we also want to study the reliability, validity and all. So without data collection, some of the researchers are finding out and calculating their validity or reliability. So in this case, we simply reiterate the words. So if the editors will identify, then they will have, it is a good, it is a very big mistake, and definitely they will reject the paper. So do not ignore work in agreement with yours, and convince the readers. First, very, very important, the reader should be convinced. Who is the first reader? The editor is the first reader. Who is your second reader? The reviewer of your research paper is a second reader. And who is a third reader? After publishing the research paper, whoever is reading your research work. Okay, there are three readers. Okay, and scientific tense, very, very important, dear faculty colleagues. Please use present tense for known fact and hypothesis, like the average life of honeybees. Past tense, whenever the experiment have already conducted. Okay, all the honeybees were maintained, and also past tense when you are going to describe the results on your experiment. The average lifespan of bees in our contained environment was 8 weeks. So this research work or article writing is already concluded work. It is not ongoing work. Whenever you are writing a research paper, please use present tense for known fact and hypothesis, and past tense for experiments, and also past tense for writing a results of a particular experiment. And conclusion part, I told you the conclusion is a smile. Okay, conclusion is your smile of the research paper. Tells how your work is advances. Do not repeat abstract, very, very important, dear friends. Don't repeat the abstract in the conclusion part. And conclusion part should be very unique. Along with the conclusion, please mention the future experiments. I told you it should be better. You can include the along with the conclusion, separate chapter can be added, like policy implications and future work. If the journal is required only 5 chapters, then you can, along with the conclusion, you can write limitation, policy implications and future work. Okay, that is very, very important. Acknowledgement, if suppose the research is carried out with some research fund or research grant, don't forget to mention the grant number and all. It is not required to mention always, like advisors, financial supporters, proofreaders. In case of development studies, in case of economic research and all, some of the researcher will give the acknowledgement to advisor, financial supporters and all, but not always. References is another important part, very very important. Writing a reference required more stylish, more knowledge. Today more number of softwares are available, more mistakes are found in the references. Even I can say there are number of papers are rejected because you are not following the good reference style. The 95% of the journals are requested us to submit the references in the form of APA, American Psychological Association format. Some of other acceptable formats are MLA style and Chicago style. Okay, so it is one of the most annoying problems. If you miss one pair, one comma, one full stop, then it is the paper will not be accepted. So avoid excessive self citation. Again, self citation means suppose your work again cited from the second paper or third paper, it should be avoid. Okay, these are all the components of the business research article for management, economics and other social science people. Whatever we discussed so far, it is okay. Again, I just make it as in a more simpler format that I have added with that for your easy understanding, I have given here. But whatever we discussed so far, it is included even for writing business article or business research article or social science or engineering, any field. Normally in the business research article, first chapter is introduction, second chapter review of literature, third chapter is methodology part. Under methodology, we are using statement of the problem, objectives, hypothesis and methods. And fourth one is results and discussion. And after that acknowledgement, I have not added the word called conclusion, sorry. Conclusion should be important. Yeah. Results and discussion, then conclusion, then acknowledgement. So this is first chapter is introduction. Just a second. Introduction is the first one. Second one is review of literature. Third one is a methodology. Okay. Under methodology only, we are writing the different things. And fourth one is results and discussion, and fifth one is conclusion. I hope now you can able to view my presentation. Introduction, review of literature, methodology, under methodology, problem, objective, hypothesis, results and discussion, and conclusion. Again, this is the same manner, title. I just make it the title. What is wrong with this title? A granular and casualty approach in explaining the relationship between money output and price level of India during 1950s-2003. Here, you need not mention the study period in the title. Study period is not required. Okay? I just make it as a better title, like relationship between money output and price level in India, a granular casualty approach. It should be very clear and precise and more attractive also. Okay. And the review of literature, problem, objectives, very important and pivotal section. Too many objectives can be avoided. Objectives should be specific, achievable and measurable. Okay, and objectives should start with the two. Okay, and the formulation of hypothesis is also important. And any empirical research article, we need formulation of hypothesis. Okay, formulation of hypothesis, it is very important. Hypothesis to be formulated and it should be tested with some statistical test, very important. If you are mentioned in the hypothesis, then definitely you should be tested. Research methodology part, here you want to mention what type of research, quantitative or qualitative. Then after quantitative and qualitative, what type of research design? Either it is a descriptive or analytical. After the research design, we want to move to sampling design. in the sampling design, what type of sampling technique, probability or non-probability, under probability which technique, then sample size, then sampling area. So that is sampling design. Then data design, primary data or secondary data, and then tools for collection of the research data, questionnaire or any other method, and tools for statistical analysis, what type of statistical analysis you are used. Everything can be mentioned in the methodology part. Okay, and discussion, results and discussion. Here you want to answer the question posed in the introduction, discuss the weakness, explain what is new in the paper, test the hypothesis, do not repeat the result, use table, charts, figures. Very, very important, table number and table title should be given at above the table. For the figures and chart, I mean for the figures, the figure number should be given or figure title should be given at below the figures. Very important. Sources can be also given where whenever it is required. References must be relevant and recent, and we are all making a mistake in the references section. Sometime we mention in the references but not cited inside the article. Sometime we mention the author name and the year of published work in the body of the content, but we have forgotten to mention in the references section. So both are mistake. So whatever work you cited should be mentioned in the references. Whatever work you cited in the main body of the content, it should be cited in the references. So bibliography is different, references is different. Normally we using references. Okay, and that's what I told you already. So references should be cited whatever we have mentioned in the paper. And very important, why do we refer referring to leading author, illustrating and supporting, and to provide factual information, accuracy of the work, and comparing, contrasting and evaluation of the research, our research support, we are using references in our research paper. And these are all the acceptable format, American Psychological Association, Modern Language, Chicago and Caribbean, and so on. These are all the softwares, EndNote, References Manager, ProCite, and so on are available for citing the references. Apart from that, there are some other open source software also available for writing references section and citation. CitationMachine.net, Citation Builder, PipMe, CiteFast, Mentally software, all are open source software. You can easily download from the Google. Okay, you can try to use this software. If you are used to this type of software, and it is your research work will become very easy. It is not a tidy job. Okay, for citing and references. And this is very important, dear friends, to become a better writer. So write even more, keep writing. Okay, keep writing. And with this, I just conclude my session. Thank you. And now it is open the forum for discussion. If you have any questions related to this session or forthcoming session, always welcome, no issue. So tomorrow we will see about how to submit the research article in good quality journal, how to identify and what are all the journals and everything available under Scopus and Web of Science we will discuss. Any questions, please? I think some of the questions have raised from audience. First, I will look into the chat window. Just a second. Yeah, any questions? Any code for joining the meeting? Okay.
Thank you, sir. But
policy implications. ma'am, ma'am, please, just a second, ma'am. Sunita, ma'am, just a second. Just a second, ma'am. I will go with the some questions raised in the chat window. Then I will come with your question. How to update recent review when paper is submitted to journal? No, after submission of your journals, it is not possible. Maybe at the time of revision on your research paper, if you require, you can add, include. Sometimes in the review comments itself, the reviewer will point out recent review may be cited. If it's so, then you can add. This is the answer for Rasmi Lad question. Satya Ranjit is asked about the question, how to check the journal is in Scopus or not. So this topic, we will cover it tomorrow, sir. Okay, tomorrow I will teach you how to check the journal is in Scopus or not. And which one have more weightage to publish paper in Scopus or Web of Science? Definitely I will say Web of Science journals, Science Citation Indexed journals. This is an answer for Desmuk. H-index, Web of Science, what do you mean by H-index, Preeti Gupta? We will discuss at day after tomorrow, what do you mean by H-index? And what is Web of Science for Desmuk again, we will discuss on tomorrow. About funding research, my answer, funding, so many funding agencies are available. And if you want to get or crack more funding from the different funding agencies, publications is important. And we also have separate session on funding research on this month. Okay. And at the time you will get more important information on funding research. Some journals are reject your paper. Can we use it for another journal? Definitely. But very important, Sailesh sir, please change it whenever the corrections have pointed out by the reviewer. Then you can submit for some other journal. Even the same journal you can submit if the scope is matched, but after do some weldering or dingering you want to do, then you can submit it. Plagiarism is an important issue. Definitely we will discuss the plagiarism in day after tomorrow. I will give the only three techniques for removing reducing the plagiarism: phrasing the sentence, re-alter the sentence. So no other way. But now there are so many plagiarism softwares are available, paid softwares like Urkund is there, and you go for Authenticate is there. There are so many softwares. You can check it with them, and you will get good feedback after if you are submitting the research paper after removing the plagiarism with the help of plagiarism software. And is it possible for me to publish research papers with my students' project? Definitely it is possible, but more work it is needed, more research point of view it is required. Students' project is different, article is different. Okay. I don't know, what do you mean by LR minimum required? Sailendra Darkar, ma'am? I don't know, I'm not understand what is LR.
Literature reviews.
Yeah.
Literature reviews, sir. How many literature reviews?
Correct. Sorry. So literature review, it is not like that, sir. Maybe 10, 15, according to me, I can say 10 to 15 literature review for writing a review paper. Sorry, for writing a research article. But inside the introduction part, methodology part, analysis part, even conclusion part, you may get some citations. Okay. For at least you may, if any good quality journals, if you found, the average references must be 35 to 45, sir. At least 35 references or 40 references if you provide, then it will be a, it will consider it is a good paper.
Okay. Can I ask questions?
Yes, sir. I will come later. Don't worry, sir. If journal reject the paper after making necessary changes, can we submit? Yes, we can submit it. Grammar check, Grammarly software are available, ma'am. Nalini, ma'am. Grammarly softwares are available. Online SEO tools are available. I suggest you please consult with any nativity speaker or in our language teacher, English teacher, before submitting the research paper. That is very important. When you are going to submit the research paper for InterScience and other type of journal, definitely language correction is important. Should we include findings one sentence, one or two sentence on your brief on findings can be included in abstract. Most of the Scopus journals are hybrid, so how to find? Yes, sir, Resmi, Lad ma'am, we will discuss tomorrow, don't worry about. Can we use the word ECC to cite number 8 of good qualities of paper? I can't understand. 8 of good qualities paper. ECC, what is ECC, ma'am? Seri Mera? I don't know. Maybe we will get it later. Hema Patel, can you throw some light on Scopus publication? Definitely, we will discuss on tomorrow how writing project work. Project work is different. So many questions we are receiving. Thank you, my dear researcher. Writing a project work is different, ma'am. Sunita, ma'am, writing a research project work is different.
Okay, sir.
You are asking about. MPhil dissertation or any type of project?
Sir, I have done PhD in psychology.
Yes, ma'am.
My field is home science, human okay. development.
Very good, ma'am. Very good, ma'am.
And I have done a PhD in psychology.
Okay.
So I am interested in research work. And how great, can great. Done?
You want
I have no field? Godfather. I have no godfather who to teach me about that. Long time I'm see some person guide me and how write it,
ma'am. And for in psychology field, there is a good scope for writing a research paper, as well as if you are working in college or university.
I am teaching in a college, private college. Good, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You have a lot of opportunity to write a research proposal for doing a project, funding project. You can apply for UGC, ICSSR, so many organizations are available.
But especially, sir, I know you give me in your next day teaching class.
Yeah, definitely, ma'am, definitely. We are going to conduct a funding proposal, how to write a fund proposal for funding agencies, maybe. Next month we are going to hold a session.
Because sir, no one.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, I am not in touch. I am very thankful to that I take your class, workshop class, because no one teach me like that.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
From private college in Jaipur, Rajasthan University.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
In rural area.
Oh, right. But according to me, in psychology, there is a lot of scopes are available.
Thank you, sir.
Even so many good quality journals are available. I can show it to you. Maybe after the question session, if you require, I can show it to you, one of the paper. And Silas have asked about, as a researcher, what type of paper publishing is a good. Definitely, I can say that research paper, sir. No review paper. Review paper is the first thing. But definitely, as a researcher or a MPhil researcher or any researcher, you will receive good citation only using the research data. Okay. How can other people join with Sunita Parekh, ma'am? I don't know how. I'm not understand about your question.
Sir, I know. How can I join with? You are showing me that multiple people join with you in an international work. Okay. So
collaboration. Yeah, I will tell you tomorrow, ma'am. I will tell you tomorrow. This is more on collaboration work.
Yeah. And sir, there's more a on,
now collaboration is need. Collaboration is need. Yeah. Now it is open to forum. If you have any questions, I have already answered the questions. So many questions from chat window. Tomorrow I will tell you, ma'am, Chitra ma'am, tomorrow I will tell you some journals, Scopus journals related to your field, how to identify and everything I will tell you, don't worry, ma'am. If you have any open question, please ask.
Sir, can I ask question?
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for a lovely session. It's a lot of inputs. I got it. I am doing a research paper, sir, on hospitality industry, hotel restaurant industry. So it is a new concept which is available abroad, farm to restaurant procuring stuff, but it is not popular in my district, Pune district, and not popular in Maharashtra state. So there is literature is only available in form of articles, and there is no research paper literature available in India. I've been through Shodhganga, I've been all the sites, but I have a good literature abroad from reputed journal. So is it okay? Is it fine that I go ahead with this research paper?
Definitely, sir. Definitely. It is not required to cite on Indian articles or Indian context. Definitely, you go with the articles available with you from the different sources from different countries. Almost, I can say that it is a good. Okay, you are not going to publish in Indian journal. So mostly it is in international journals. We need a good quality research paper. But you can, your context is different, that's all.
Okay, okay. I can give references of article and about the same topic. Same question pertaining to that. There are very few restaurants operating this system, specifically in Mumbai. So I approach them and send them questionnaire, and on a telephonic interview,
sir,
I did a few data collection.
Sir, in, I last couple of months, I have found so many research articles are published in hospitality, tourism and hospital industry. Hospitality, that is hotel and restaurant industry, and hospital industry also. In the good quality journals, I have received a message from LinkedIn. So many people are working on hospitality management, hospital administration, hotel service quality, and so many issues. And the journals are also available. The high indexed journals are also available in the field of hospitality. So my best wishes for you, sir. You can stick on the same line so that there are a lot of opportunities. Collaborate with some researchers who are more familiar. Maybe you can collaborate with some of the co-authors. So definitely your research work will be accepted.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your guidance. Thank you.
Ma'am, Hema ma'am, do you have any question? You have raised a hand. Hema ma'am.
Yes, sir. Nowadays, through conferences, Scopus, this thing, you know, is being...
Ma'am, frankly, I am telling, last 2 months back, there are so many conferences proceedings are indexed by Scopus, like IOP, AAP and all. Last month, the conferences, two, three IOP conference, AAP conference proceedings, it was discontinued from Scopus list, ma'am. Now, it was very limited scope on the conference proceedings, but it is still available, but before going to send the research paper and publish in the conference proceedings, please check it with whether the paper is going to index it or not. That you want to check and submit, ma'am.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Any more questions? We don't have any feedback form for today's session. We will have the compile feedback form at last date for receiving certificate as well as feedback.
Sir, how can I know about conferences or workshops or seminars? How can, because I have not attached any link. I want link. This is my some academic friend. He sent me. Then I join you. Then how many I join, so many research work here, so many educational work.
Ma'am, you can join with any of the WhatsApp group, Telegram group. So many fields are available today, ma'am. You mentioned you can join with this academic group. There are so many people are available so that you can receive more information, conference information frequently.
No, no, sir. How can I know that this is academic group or this is this name is this field here? This is conference or seminar or this group is this?
Ma'am, you can visit conferencealert.com. Conferencealert.com.
Conferencealert.com.
Yeah. You will get lot of information.
Thank you, sir. And seminar and workshop also.
Everything.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Very good session, sir. Excellent.
Thank you, ma'am. Sagila, ma'am, do you have any
questions? Yes, sir.
Please, ma'am.
Sir, actually, I have published around 4 to 5 articles in journals.
Very good.
But that does not belong to any Scopus or peer reviewed journals.
Okay.
Actually, recently when I attended an interview, they allocated grades for the Great. Journals.
Okay.
But when I showed them these journals, it was rejected, and they said that it is not accepted for mark
yes,
session.
Ma'am. Definitely, ma'am.
So I have a doubt. Like, is it possible for me to rewrite these articles into
no.
a Scopus journal or?
No, ma'am. It is very difficult. You can rewrite, but the topic from everything you want to change. Otherwise,
I have to change the topic. Yes, sir. And I also have one more question. Like, I asked you about my students' projects.
Yeah.
Mostly the students.
You can easily convert the students' project.
Yeah,
into
but paper. I have doubt. Like, because most of my students do projects under a company. It's not open projects.
Correct,
so
correct.
How is it possible for me to publish it as an article? Because I have to get permission from the companies also.
Correct.
Which is not
so
possible.
In this case, you convert the research project into general project.
Okay.
I mean generally. Say instead of collecting the data on only one company, you just make it as 5 companies, 6 companies like that. Okay. Then you can easily convert the project into article.
For example,
there is a very little scope to publish your research project if you are adopted with any company name.
Yeah.
Better you don't mention any company name in the title. Without mentioning the company name, you can rewrite the project into article format. Then you can publish it.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Good evening. You told the name of from this we can get the information. This conference alert.
Sir.
Sir, this is Shomnath. This
okay.
I want to know what was the madam was asking from where we can take the information about the different conferences. The
sir,
site you
conferencealert.com, sir.
Alert.
I will just a second. I will post it in the Google chat window. Just a second.
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
Now you can take it.
Oh,
so many websites are there.
Along. Okay.
Alerts.
Okay.
Ma'am, Seri Makra, ma'am, do you have any question?
Yes, sir. Sir, actually, I want to share that I have sent my paper for a conference, and they sent me a plagiarism report about my paper. They said that it is highly plagiarized. And when
okay.
I checked that plagiarism report, the particular tool did that, the particular schemes of my topic, it was on a mutual funds, and that tool plagiarized the particular names of that mutual fund scheme.
Okay.
So what is the solution for that, sir? Because the particular scheme names will be as it is in everywhere, na? So how we can say that
correct,
it is plagiarized?
Correct. Ma'am, I don't know which tools they have used for checking the plagiarism.
I'll tell. It's a website, urukunda.com, something was like that.
Yeah, Urukunda is a good tool, ma'am, but I don't know. Definitely, if it mutual fund are all exclusively acceptable words, common words while we are writing a research paper, but definitely I don't know. Maybe how they have calculated the plagiarism, but if you are using the mutual fund on different times, different words, there are possibilities in the software. Multiple words can be avoided. There is a one options are available even in Urukunda word and some other words. Okay.
Turnitin, whatever Turnitin.
Yeah, Turnitin and all. Yes, sir. Correct. Exactly.
2 to 3 words are similar, it is considered as a plagiarism.
Correct, 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 exactly correct, sir. So you may check it with some other journal, ma'am. Sorry, some other software. Okay.
Okay. And one more thing, sir, that particular tool, what did that? Like we have a topic, like we have a heading for a paragraph, like a research methodology word, right? And the particular tool also plagiarized that word. The particular tool plagiarized the heading of a paragraph.
Yeah, yeah. That's everywhere is same, ma'am. Because suppose I am using a factor analysis, you are also using factor analysis. The factor analysis is a plagiarized word. That it is not a countable. Don't worry, ma'am. It should not countable. Don't worry.
One more thing, sir. Is a self plagiarism is allowed?
No. Okay. Better you can avoid.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you so much.
Unless otherwise, it is very important for the current research paper. You can use. Otherwise, it may be avoid.
Sir, actually the tables and results of my research paper was similar to my previous paper.
No,
I can't change the results na values like.
No, actually, I don't know how.
Or I can what situation, give the citation, like na.
No, ma'am, your title is relevant with the mutual fund, but the previous study is different. This study is different. Okay, maybe some previous study you might use gold mutual fund. Gold ETF. Now you are using maybe index mutual fund. That the terminology is different. The concept is different. You are not a science researcher. You are using a social science researcher. So every time your way where you are attract or writing a research paper is different. You are not using a early research or existing research or extension on your research. Okay, it is a new research only. So here self citation is not permissible. Say suppose in the mathematics, say example mathematics, suppose somebody is founder or arrived the word called fuzzy graph. Suppose I am using indigenistic fuzzy graph. Somebody they may go for extension of indigenistic to domination of indigenistic fuzzy graph. So in this case, you may go for self citation, but your way of approach is different, ma'am. So my humble advice is don't use citation.
Okay, sir. Okay. And I must ask for the particular scheme names, right?
Correct.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much for such a lovely session.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. If you have any other questions, we will carry it. Otherwise, we will continue in the tomorrow also.
I have a small query here.
Yeah, please.
Sir. I'm actually a new scholar, and then I have never published any kind of articles in journals. Right.
Okay.
So I am planning to start with writing an article or a journal, but I am confused of selecting the title or where to start, how to start, of comparing with other articles or other journals and research papers and all. I'm really confused of all these things. So could you please highlight to me, like, how do I start in the beginning for all these kind of things?
It is a very good question, ma'am. So first, try to identify your research area or interest where you wish to do the research. Okay. Then accordingly. Ma'am, hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please. First, try to identify the research interest or research area you wish to perform. Then, based on the research area, you can collect the research papers. Okay?
Okay, sir.
There are some search engines like Procast, like Procast, EBSCOhost is there. From EBSCOhost,
sir, could you please tell me the spellings of all those things?
EBSCOhost. One second. EBSCOhost.
Procast.
Okay. Procast. Okay. Right?
Yes, sir.
From this platform, or you go with the Science Direct?
Sorry.
Science Direct. Emerald.
Okay.
Elsewhere. Okay.
Yes,
so
sir.
In these sites, you will identify good quality research journals and
okay,
study
sir.
That. Identify the base paper. Identify the
okay.
base paper that is more relevant for your study. Okay.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Then choose your research and go ahead.
Okay.
Then first try to collect 100 articles.
Uh-huh.
Okay, 100 research paper, review of literature paper. After
okay.
100 research paper, shortlist to 50, which is more common to your research topic. From
okay.
the 50, 10 is more relevant to your research, and 3 or 5 may be more suitable
mm-hmm.
for your study. Based
okay.
on that, you can do the research.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. And
yes.
then... After going through these articles and journals, so like plagiarism, that thing is there. So then how do I, like, do I have to write everything by myself or what should
yeah,
I do?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You want to do yourself. Plagiarism, you can easily check it.
Is there any kind of software?
Yeah, yeah,
it
is available. Online plagiarism softwares are available.
Uh-huh.
And also... Urkund software, Urkund, iThendicate.
Sorry, sir, could you please write that for me?
Yeah, Urkund software.
I could you please write that spelling for me?
Yeah, I have given.
Okay, thank you, sir.
And see, there is a one software in online plagiarism. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Small.
Yes, sir.
One second. Small SEO tools.
Okay, sir.
We take it here.
I need the spelling.
Yeah, yeah. Small SEO
okay,
tools.com, Turn Train. So many tools are available.
Okay, sir. So after finishing the journals and articles, I should. Insert them and then that way I will find or how do I use actually?
Which one?
How do I check my plagiarism?
Yeah, yeah, that's what I told you. These are all the websites are available, softwares
okay.
are available, you can check it.
Yes,
Urkund, iThendicate, Turnitin, etc.
Okay, okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. So thank you, friends. Thank you. It is ma'am, Divya ma'am, shall we conclude?
Yes, sir. Thank you, everyone, for your patient presence here inside the session. And we can continue the session, or you can ask your questions in the tomorrow session or in the day after tomorrow session also. Thank you, everyone. We hope to see you tomorrow by 5:45 p.m. in the evening.
Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.